Hi all, welcome to my channel, welcome to my world, this is the world away. We now got box 6, which is stages 21 to 24 of the IXO Collections release of build the Porsche 917kh. Now I hope I can help you out on the channel with this one because the instructions haven't been translated to English yet. So I'm going to be referring to the pictures on this and putting them on the screen and showing you what to do. Now there isn't much to do in this. But this might be, or have the potential, to be the longest video that we've done so far on this collection. And the reason being is we're going to be doing the HT leads. And I'm going to be doing the HT leads completely different to what the, well, not completely different, a little bit different to what the instructions say. But when we come to that stage, I will show you exactly what I'm doing. But if you want to get this for yourself, I'll put the link down here to the IXO Collections website. You can get this all the way from box one. You can also get the Peugeot 205, which is normally on the top shelf there, but I've actually put it under a blanket now. We've got the bodywork on. Absolutely lovely vehicle that is as well. But there's two vehicles now that you can get from IXO Collections. But without further ado, let's get cracking. So as you can see here, in stage 21, we're going to be continuing with the exhaust system that we were working on last time. I'm just going to put that to one side and bring over this absolutely brilliant engine here, which looks like that. And as you can see, last time, turn it upside down, we completed this exhaust system here. What we're going to be doing is we're going to be building onto this section just here. So, first thing I'm going to do, turn the engine over, and we've got the left side of the engine and the right side of the engine. Now these are labeled different. You've got the left side with an L on it and the right side with an R on it. So I'm going to keep those to one side. We're going to put the left side in first. The left side's got a lug just over the top there. That's going to go in here like this. And it's going to be held in through the top with a BP screw. That looks like that. And I'll get that attached. Start off nice and slow to start, and then we can make that fully tight. Just turning it round, we want to take its partner here and push that lug into the hole here. So that clips in, and then we're going to hold it at this side with an AP screw. Two different screws for one little bit of exhaust system there. We're going to do the right hand side here again. So again, we just push that up there, put a BP screw just down the top. Like that. And then once again, we're going to put the end on, making sure we push that lug into place, and then hold that all together with an AP screw. And there we go, that's all together. So that's those two flutes in. All we're going to do then is we've got these tops to put on here. We're going to put one in like this and just attach it to the ends here. And they're going to be attached with IM screws. And there we go, that's in place. And we just do exactly the same on the other side here. IM screw just to hold that in place. And there we go. That's where we are with the exhaust system now. I'm going to turn this back over because we're about to start putting the HT leads into this side. So I will show you exactly what we're doing in stage 22. We're going to be building the distributor, then we're going to be cutting some of this piping here to start making the HT leads. Now I've already done this, but I am going to show you a technique of what I've done with that. And this is where things get fiddly because we're going to start training this around the engine, just like this. First thing we're going to do is we're going to take the base of the distributor looking like this, and we're going to be attaching these together. Now they should fit in perfectly, so that little notch there is lined up. We're going to put it in with an AP screw. You should have one of those left over from the last stage. So screwing that in nice and tight, and there we go, that's the distributor all in one go. We're going to be putting the plugs into the end here. Now these are what the plugs look like. You've got a thin end and a thick end. I'm going to be using my magnifying glasses for this to push these all into place. I think tweezers are actually your friend on this. I'm finding it a lot easier doing this with tweezers with flat ends on them. And when they're all in place, they should look just like that. Then we're going to put this over onto the engine. Now I'm going to put this on in the direction that they've got it in the books. Basically, the two middle plugs here are perpendicular to the fuel injectors there, but they are furthest away, if you can see that. And then we're going to need to cut down some of this cable here. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut the first one. I've already made these already, but I want to show you the technique that I use to do that. Now the first one needs to be cut at 10 centimeters, so I've got my ruler here. All I did was I measured 10 centimeters on my ruler, got my sprue cutters, cut it at the 10 centimeter mark there. Then the magic happens because I've got my wire here. Now this is 5 amp fuse wire. 5 amp fuse wire is the perfect thickness for this to be inserted down into the ends. Now the instructions don't tell you to do this. This is my own modification. So once you put that through, you want the wire to come out the end. So I'll get that out the end here. So as you can see there, then you want to put it back about a centimeter, so that the wire is now around about there. Cut that again with the wire right at the end. Move that to one side. And then I use a cocktail stick to push the wire down at the end here. And now what that's doing is it means that we've got a space just at the top here and a space just at the bottom here to put onto the pegs of the distributor and the spark plugs. But that is pretty much how I do all of these HT leads. So now we know that, the first one I'm going to do, I'm going to use the one that I've just created here, and we're going to be putting that into the spark plug, which is the second one in from the middle bracket there. So that's going to go in here, push that all the way down. It's then going to go round the fuel injector and through the first trumpets that we've got on either side here. So it's going to be going into here like that. Let me just show you that on the camera. And then this is where you're going to need your tweezers again, because this is going to be plugged into the plug which is nearest to those trumpets. So I've got that in here, pushing that on. And that's in. Now the advantage of it being wire is now I can bend this and it will keep and maintain its shape. Now I'll tidy that all up afterwards when I've got all the rest of them in, but let's do the second one. Now once again, the second one needs to be 10 centimeters. This is going onto the plug that's nearest to this other side here. So I'll put it on. There we go. And once again, it's going to follow the same course that the one we've just done follows. So up here, round the trumpet, and this one's going to the plug just to the left of that one. Again, probably look at the pictures and that will show you perfectly how this goes. Now the third lead is 12 centimeters, and this one's going on the second to end plug. Put that on here, and again it's following the same route as all the other ones here. Now the fourth one is 12.5 centimeters, and that's going from the very end this time, this one over here, and once again following the route of all the others. We're going in a clockwise direction around these pins. The next one is 12 centimetres. That's the third one in here. Once again, following the route. To the next one along. Another 12 centimetre one now. This is going on the third one from the middle. Another 10 centimetre one now, which is going to go into this one here between the first two on this side. Once again, following the route of all the rest of them. Now I am going to employ my old friend some glue here just to help keep these on, because the more we add, the more they're going to want to come off. Slightly different one this time. This is 10.5. This is going between these ones here. I didn't mention it last time, but the last one we put in actually goes between these two trumpets. So most of the first ones went through these two. These ones we're putting in now are going to go through these two here. Another 12 centimeter one. This is going into the spark plug right at the end, following the same route as the last two that we've put in. You know, I get this far and I realise that it's a lot easier to actually put the ends in the distributor first and then put the other ends in the spark plug. But there you go. You live and learn. Now we need an 11.5 one, looking like that. That's going in this one over here, which again, I think I will put in the distributor first. So we're looking like that now. You can see how fiddly this is. Which then leaves two 10.5 ones. First one is going into this point here, but once again, I will put it in the distributor first, which means the last one is just going into the plug nearest to the center here. So I'll just plug that into the last port that I've got here. Again, following the routes of all the other cables, and they are all in place. Now the wire actually helps that you can mold all of these round into place. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to tidy them up. Now the advantage of wire them up is that I can actually have them molded to the exact way I want, so it looks a lot neater on the top here. But that was very fiddly. Now, just when you think you're safe to go back in the sea, we've got stage 23, which we're doing exactly the same thing, making a distributor, and then we're cutting the cables and doing the exact, because he's obviously got two distributors in this house. So as you can see, by the end of it, the engine is going to look just like that. So no different to what we did last time. We're going to be cutting the plugs for the distributor off the sprue here. And then just like last time, I'm going to put these in my tweezers and push these into the distributor cap. So I'll come back when they're all pushed in. So there we go. Distributor completed again. Put the top on here, making sure it's round the right way, and then held in with an AP screw. Bring over the engine again. This time the distributor's going on the other side here. And just like last time, we're going to have the two points here into the middle of the engine when I put this on. So it's going to go on just like that. Now the sizes are different on this one. The first one is a 7.5, which looks like that. That's going into the plug nearest to the trumpets here. I'm just putting a little bit of glue on that. And I am going to do it this way this time. I'm going to put it into the plug first, like that, and then feed it to where it goes. So it goes over the top here, and this one is going into the third pin along here. The second one is an 8.2 centimeter one. Again, we're working clockwise on this, so that's going to go into the next pin along here, and that one's going into the second pin from this middle section here. So I'll get that one in just like that. And again, because the wire's in there, I can actually shape it so they fit nice, a lot nicer on there. Next one along is a 9.8 centimeter one. Push that on there. This one is going onto the first pin, just onto the other side of the engine here. Next one is a 12 centimeter one. This one's going in the second from the end over here. Next one along is an 8.5 centimeter, and that's going into the first pin on this side here. Next one, 9 centimeter. This one's going on the third one along here. Then we've got 10.5 centimeters. Now this is what going next to the one we've got here, but this time we're going through the middle two trumpets here. Next one is an 11.5 centimeter, and that one, middle two trumpets again, and that's going in the very end one. Next one is 10.5. The glue is just stopping these pinging off in all directions. This one goes onto the second of the end over here. Then we need a 9.5. And this is going into the one nearest to the center column here. Then we need a 10.5. That one's going in the second along from this side. Then an 11. And that will be the last one. So I'll just tidy these wires up. Like that on both sides, put that one all down. And there we go. All in place, pretty tricky. But there you go, that's exactly how it should look. Pretty happy with that, that took a while though. Which means the last stage here, we're actually just doing a little bit of the expansion tank here. That's all we're doing. We're actually just going to be putting these sections together just like this here. And at the end of it, that's all we're going to do. So it looks just like this. So the first thing I do is going to be taking the expansion tank. We're going to be putting a pipe just on the top here, like that. We're going to be putting this section here, just on the end. Just get this in. So it pushes in like that, and then the pipe connects to the top of that section there. Now we have got a cap to put on the top here. The cap's in its own bag. Looks just like this. It's the same color as the expansion tank here. You just push that on here. We're going to be attaching this to this A-frame here. It's going to be going on this way. Line everything up. Got some lugs to line up here. There you go. And that's held in with an AP screw. Then we've got a surround to keep that into place here, which looks like that. That's just going to go this lug here through the hole at the top. And then we push all the other lugs into the holes around each side. So that's one, two, just this one, three. That's going to hold that into place. We're then going to be making the reservoir here. So once again, we've got a pipe which we're going to put onto the smaller nipple at the top, push that down. At the other side, we've got a cap to put on. And then this is going to be pushed into the bracket that we've got here. Push that in like that. Do the same on the other one here. So we've got a cap that's going on the top. I just wondered where my pipe went. The pipe that I put in here isn't this one. Look, I've got a clear one here. So I'm going back to the expansion tape. See, I make mistakes so you don't have to. And I'll just put this pipe into place. This is a clear pipe. No wonder I missed it. I bet you're all screaming at the screen then. That goes on here like this. And then the top unlike that. You can see that I film these live, can't you? Anyway, so that's that, which means now I've got the pipe for the bottom of this reservoir. Like that. Once again, we're going to put this one in the other side here. Clip that in. So now they look like that. And then all we've got to do is close that off on this side with this clip with the lugs facing outwards. So it's going to go on like that there. Put the other side in and that there. There we go. That's how that looks. All we've got to do is clip that to the A-frame then. Into the two holes that we can see down there. And there we go. That's what that looks like. And that is all there is to do in that stage. That's all there is to do in that pack. Well, that was enjoyable, wasn't it? I thoroughly enjoyed doing that. That took, let's have a look. We've got the recording time here. 1.5 hours to do. Bearing in mind that I had already pre-prepared the HT leads. So that's probably added another hour to it, getting all of those ready for this build. But I'm sure you'll agree. Let me bring the engine over. That this is coming along. Looking pretty cool. And that's what it looks like from that stage. So if you want to get this for yourself, I've put the link down the bottom again here. IXO Collections website. You can get this all the way from pack one. But I really do hope you liked that video. If you did, please remember to give me a thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed already, just realized I didn't have my hat on. Please remember to subscribe. Other than that, take care.